You guys ready for another Dirty Digger's adventure? Good. Scoot over. I'm driving.
That's a silver ring. Yes, baby.
It says Cubs, BSA, and it's definitely an older ring.
Chad just got a Merc. I've actually pulled two Wheaties out of here so far.
Oh, that's a Mercury Dime. We like Mercury Dimes.
Go ahead and clean it up and let us know.
Yeah, not bad, huh?
That's fine, buddy. Give me some up. All right, Mad Chad, what you got there, buddy? 1943 war nickel.
So, I gotta see the shiny.
Gotta see the shiny.
Oh, Buffalo nickel. Sweet.
Yeah. I just found that SLQ right here.
There is no date on it, of course.
And now you gotta go sit on the curb because you'll only be here, what, 5 seconds and you already found a weedy?
Hey guys, here we go again, another Dirty Digger's adventure. Today we're with Ken from American Patriot Adventures. How's it going, buddy?
It's going great. We got our first weedy of the day.
Got the first weedy. Let's go check it out.
It's pretty chewy. At least got some crud on the front. I thought it 40s at first, but might be earlier.
Yeah, she's got that red color to her.
Yep.
Yeah, she is a little chewy.
I think it might be crud, though. We might be able to clean her up and get a date off.
We'll see if we can get a date off of it.
Yeah, well, that's a good first 5 minutes.
Yep, that's great.
All right.
Anyways, he got us his permission. Ken invited us out to one of his spots. I'm very thankful for that because look at this beautiful house. Built in 1885. Looks to be original yard. I'm pretty sure it hasn't been hunted. He just found a weedy right on top, so that's a very good sign that it hasn't been hunted, but we'll know as soon as we get a little further into this hunt what we start pulling out. But hey, one weedy so far. He's got his bifocals out, so he's looking at something. I'm curious, what you got? Don't do that, you're scary.
I can't even tell. I couldn't even tell you what it was.
What do you think it is?
I don't know, I see a Lincoln on the front.
Okay.
And I think a one cent on the back, but...
An old crusty old, yeah, it's a weedy, I can see.
It ain't never gonna...
Crusty old weedy.
Crusty,
there's
crusty.
Number two, crusty old weedy. Chad just got a seeded dime. His very first seeded dime, isn't it, Chad?
Yes, sir.
Awesome. She's a little slick.
Oh, okay.
See it?
We can get a day. I can see
okay,
a day.
Okay, I can see 1867.
67, that's what I thought, too. That's
one dime. Yeah.
That's right around Civil War.
1860, just after.
Yeah. That's great. That yep, just after Civil
for
War.
30 years, probably, but.
Oh, yeah, that thing's slick. Can I get a peek at it?
Oh, yeah. 1867.
Let me get a little zoomy.
Oh,
there's his first seated. Good job,
think of
buddy.
The story that coin could tell.
Oh, for sure.
They go one dime. She's slick, but I guess you don't care, do you? Awesome.
That is so great.
You got to give me some knuckles on that one. So not only is this Chad's first 1800s coin, first seated, awesome little flying. She is slick, you know, but for Chad's first 1800s coin, man, you can't ask for much more than that. 1867. Man, she's slick as a baby's butt, but pretty cool, man. Anyways, let's go see what Chad's up to. Sometimes it sucks being the cameraman because you don't get as much time on the coil as these guys do. I'm always running around to see who's finding what. You got a 1918 weedy, yeah?
Yes, sir.
Can right, I see it?
Actually, right about where your foot's at.
Right in here?
Yeah, and then right in that corner.
And then right in here is where he's got that seeded dime.
Basically on the corner where the dirt and the grass meet.
Seeded dime right over there. And this this fountain here is original to the property.
There you go.
So Chad was smart to come to this area first. Yep. Man, all these weedies have been coming out really roasty.
Yeah, they have.
That's a 1918. That's a nice early wheat penny. But definitely ain't going to be worth nothing. For some reason, I don't know why, but this ground is not very good on these coins.
Take a lot of fertilizer, maybe? I know back east you see a lot of that where they're just so beat up from the fertilizer.
Yeah, from the fertilizer.
We
generally
pull weedies out better than that, and it wasn't that
Oh, deep, I know. It's
so
crazy.
I don't know.
61006. Now, just looking at the age, I'm going to guess that's 1906. Definitely enameled. Got some fancy little designs on it. Pretty cool. I heard you found a American Revolutionary War button.
We did. We got a...
Might have been something like that. Let's see here. First off, let me show you my shield nickel.
Yeah, doesn't that cool?
Hey, look at my shield nickel there. It's one of them heavily green models. Got an eagle shield, but boom, no cash value.
Wah, wah.
And there's my wheat penny.
Okay.
Which
see
it's
some
a
silver.
It's a 1940 something, and then I got me a last year silver.
64? Yep, got the 64 taken care of.
Barely squeaked in there.
Yeah, good. Hey, it's silver. That's all that matters.
That's it.
Good job.
You gotta see the shiny.
Gotta see the shiny. All right, here's a cool little find. Ken just found this. It doesn't have much weight to it. I'm thinking it's a plated piece, but looks like it has an opal or some kind of stone right in the middle of it. Personal item, pretty cool.
Oh, that's a mercury dime. We like mercury dimes.
There she be. Hey, we got silver. That's nice. I didn't video my two Wheaties. You have to take my word for it. They were from the 50s. I didn't
them.
Honestly think we were going to find a whole lot out of
I
here.
I saw them.
Yeah, Chad saw them. All right. Hey, nice find, dude.
Yes,
give
sir.
Us a bump. Mr. Mad Chad showed up. What's
what
up, buddy?
Found a wheat penny already. I know I didn't come by and say hi yet, but I stood out front and found a weedy.
All right,
give
you
me
got
a year on that. So anyways, that mercury dime I dug yesterday, 1921D.
Right.
Our coin guy owned a jewelry shop. He graded it right about
Chuck.
In a fine chuck.
How much is it worth?
I don't know. You know, he offered $90 for it. So, and then he's trying to get me low. So I imagine it's probably
$150, $200 coin.
I'm hoping in 20, 30 years.
Sweet.
Really
give
good.
Me some,
yeah.
baby. Hey, that's your first key date
first,
coin, isn't it?
Especially for a key date. Now, granted, it was Doug, but, you know.
Hey, that's fine, dude.
Yeah.
I found a key date this year. It was a 1904 Barber. Chad finally got a key date. Awesome. And now you got to go sit on the curb because you'll only be here, 5 seconds and you already found a weedy?
Is it green?
Well, rally count got a dime. Let me see her, bud. He missed it by 1 year. It was a 1965. 1 year off. It's all right. Hey, 10 cents richer, buddy.
That's right.
Woohoo! All right, here's our first mentionable find. I was swinging it. I was getting 89, 90. I didn't expect a wheat penny out of here. And even Relic Count came over and swung it and said he was right around 1142. But it's a wheat penny. Little corrosion on her. She looks like the 40s to me. She's got that red color. And this one is a buffalo. I'm pretty sure I can see it right here. You see the bottom. You see the leg. So let's let John clean that one up. Get a little close up. Oh, buffalo nickel. Sweet.
Yeah.
Definitely a buffalo. She's red.
It's worn
out. Wore out.
I don't think we're going to get a date off it.
You mind if I take it, John?
No.
Let's see if we can get a date off her. Boy, she is wore out. Boy, that's almost pretty slick. I doubt we're going to get a date off that. But hey, it's a buffalo. The coins we've been finding are in the 40s. So I got high hopes. We're going to get silver out of here soon. All right, check out our little helper here. Boy, this puppy is wound 440. He's a good boy. He just needs some learning. Hey. Yeah, he's already taken off with John's gloves. Stop. Anyways, cool. This is a great find right here. I knew we were going to find something good. I was getting around 86, 87. John swung it and was reading really good numbers with his E-track. That's a silver ring. Yes, baby. Loving the silver. Let's pop it out here and see what we got. Oh, it's got some writing on it. A little bit of fancy.
Cub Scout
ring.
That's awesome.
I love that. Look at that.
Nice.
Sweet. Let's clean it up. It's definitely silver, man. She was just giving that screaming tone. Very nice find. All right, look at that awesome little ring. Says Cubs BSA, and it's definitely an older ring because that sterling mark right there, I can barely read it. It's wore down flat. Right in that little square down there says sterling. Cool find. Starting to like this yard. We barely touched it. John's been working this area. He's gridded it off, and I have gridded off this area here. All right, here's a perfect example of what you should have done live, but I didn't. I'm pretty damn sure that's another war nickel. You can see that really nice shine to it. I'm going to have to clean it up to confirm it, but pretty sure that is. Now, that is the third war nickel in 2 weeks I've found. Found one on Relic Sound property not too long ago, and one at the post office. We'll clean it up. Yep, I see right there, there's the mint. So, do you see that mint mark right up top there? Right on top of the building. That tells me right there it's a war nickel. Don't even have to look at the date. All right, we'll clean it up. All right, there should be 1943 war nickel. These clean up really good because they have that silver in there. So, a little tough to get the corrosion off now, but give this a couple days soaking. Come out really nice. Alright, Relic Hound got a weedy. We're getting quite a few coins out of here. Looks like a 1941. Nice job, buddy. We barely touched this yard. We still got the whole back area to do. Alright, here we go with my next coin. Still in the clump. I was getting 81. Pretty solid. I'm kind of thinking this is probably a wheat penny. She's got some green to her. Yeah, she's a weedy. Kind of hard to see through all that corrosion. A little brown. A little brownness. It's like a 1950. Another weedy. That's definitely silver. Let me get a peek at it for you, Papa. Yeah. That's definitely silver. I think it's a rosy.
Is it?
Pretty shallow. Hard to say, but go ahead and pop her out. That's your find. nice. Maybe a Merc. We're in a spot to be a Merc. Let me see the backside, Chad. Can I steal it?
You can. Wipe it.
Yeah, it's a Merc.
Be careful. Is it? Oh, then be real careful. Oh, it is.
It's a Mercury. That's it. Mercury dime. We finally got some silver coin. I won't rub it. Go ahead and clean it up and let us know. Mad Chad got the silver done. I knew we were going to get some silver coinage out of here sometime. It's a 1939 Merc.
I don't know if you can get it or not. Let me flip it. I just want to see if you can get
just hold it right there.
Mint mark. Right, my shadows.
And that is a D mint mark.
Ooh, another D, huh?
Yep, another D.
Not too shabby. That one's in a little better shape than the last one.
Nice job, buddy.
Yeah, not
horrible. All right, I'm going to go find my own.
Do it.
Digging. Dirty diggers. What you got, Danny?
88, 91. I'm hoping this is another silver ring.
I don't believe it.
I hope so.
I don't believe it.
Chad says that because he wants one.
Yes, I do. She's still down there?
It is, still in the hole. Still a really nice solid number on that. Right in the side of that wall.
See her? Oh man, look at that sweet ass tool.
Uh-huh. She's out. Please be something good. Oh no, don't say that. Is that a modern quarter?
No.
All right, there's weedy number 500 or 502. We're getting a lot of weedies out of here. That's Mr. Relic Hound. We are finally getting our way this way. So we're just about done with this yard. Been a pretty good yard though. Got some silver, got a silver ring, buffalo nickel, war nickel. Got that really cool ring, so been a great yard, loving it. God, there's another wheat penny. This one is right in the flower bed. A little on the green side. Eh,
Yeah, a little tiny sucker, but a little pin. I don't know if that's an alpaca or a llama, the Dalai Lama. You can see the pin on the back. I thought it might be silver, but I don't know. I'll have to clean this one up and see. But hey, I mean, that's first find. Personal item. Loving it.
So Chad got us this permission, and we came back here. We got about another hour and a half, 2 hours to hunt. And I'm glad we came here. Matter of fact, we've been here before, and we only hunted a piece of it, and the landowner said he didn't really want anybody in here because of the tenants. Now the tenants are gone. We have full access, and you are not going to believe what I just found. We got big silver, baby. Let's check it out. SLQ, right? Isn't that what they call it?
Yep.
What? SLQ.
Yep. Standing yeah. Liberty Quarter.
Standing Liberty Quarter. I'm not going to rub this one.
They didn't run for very long, which is really cool.
Yeah, exactly. Like Chad said, they only ran for a few years. I'm gonna foo-foo this one, put a little juice on it. Look at that, big silver quarter. Loving that. That's my second silver today. Hey, Chad. Thank you, buddy.
Good pull.
I love your spot.
Good pull.
Usually I come up with our spots. Not that Chad's not good at it, per se. Ha-ha. But I'm just better at talking to people. Usually I can get out there and really talk and get some of these good permissions. But hey, he got this one, and I love him for it. He got me a good coin. All right, Chad's bottom feeding, but I told him to. I told him to get in here. Last time we hunted this, we hunted that part, and we hunted this part. And so I told Chad, jump in here, because this is really the only corner we didn't hunt. And I just found that SLQ right here. There is no date on it, of course. Just a bad design with this coin. The date would have been right here. But hey, I don't care. That's my second SLQ. I'm loving that. And great, great find. Big old nice piece of silver. All right, let's get back to this hunt. Wow, my very next target. Silver dime. And I'm kind of starting to think that's a Merc. Nope, it's a Rosie. Nothing wrong with a Rosie, though. We wipe Rosies. To 1952. More silver. What year you got, Mad Chad?
1942.
42 Edie.
42, yeah.
All right, hey. Been a pretty good yard. We're going to wrap it up here soon. We got kids to deal with and dinner to cook. It's been a fun hunt, though. And we're going to have to come back here and finish out this yard eventually. And we do have access, so we can always come back. But anyways, we'll see you on the next hunt, guys.